Corey, let's talk about having the advantage and how important that is under the war game rules.
Well, let's put it this way. The team that begins the match at a disadvantage remains at a disadvantage until the match officially begins once all 8 competitors, or in the men's case, 10, have entered the matchup. You could be in for an extremely long, brutal, painful night if your team's at a disadvantage.
The Bexploder by Becky Lynch. Now, in that match tomorrow night, out of the 8 women, there are only 2 women who have not had War Games experience. One is Kairi Sane, the other, believe it or not, Charlotte Flair.
Becky Lynch, part of last year's War Games match. You saw her make the tag there with Charlotte Flair. All going well so far between these deadly duo. And Charlotte Flair now with the moonsault from a height. Who's gonna take the momentum into Survivor Series War Games tomorrow night? 24 hours before Survivor Series War Games. It's Damage Control's Bayley and Asuka against Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair, who have not teamed up together in over 2 years. A lot of question marks about how they can coexist and team up here tonight.
I can't believe that this match is still going on without all these women fighting each other at ringside. It's going to be so explosive tomorrow night inside the cage.
Recall, over 47 WWE championships shared between the teams tomorrow night. Such a decorated field.
You have to take off your shoes to count that high, KP.
Look at Asuka, just ruthless. Stomping the man in the corner as the rest of Damage Control looked on.
We didn't see that, but Bayley had a handful of hair as Asuka drew the official.
Chance of Becky ring out here in Chicago. Becky once called Chicago, Illinois, her home. But it's Asuka in control here. So many storylines throughout. So many questions about Damage Control and Bayley's role within.
Who's asking these questions, KP? I mean, you and the other wedge drivers, you and the speculators, you and the internet news sites.
There's an awful lot of whispers out there. Yes, and on the internet as well, Court.
Well, you know everything's on the internet is true, right?
Oh, yeah, especially on the X.
I just can't believe Michael Cole said X.
Well, what do you want me to say? I don't want to get in trouble with the boss.
The Empress, firmly in control. And Becky Lynch a long way away from Charlotte Flair. So Corey's answered the question. He doesn't think Becky and Charlotte can get along. Cole, what do you think?
I agree with him. I agree with Corey 100%. There is no way Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch are going to be able to coexist in this match tomorrow.
Why?
Because they haven't gotten along in years, and they're just going to put it all aside for one night? I don't believe it.
The once unbreakable friendship crumbled under the weight of their shared ambition.
There's only room at the top of the mountain for one. When you're looking back at generations, the era of who represented it the best, it's got to be Charlotte or Becky.
And Bianca Belair doesn't have any love lost for those two either. So
Bianca continues to carve her legacy in her own right.
Oh,
such deeply personal rivalry between Charlotte and Becky.
And that's the thing with Damage Control. They're so tightly knit. There's a lot of history there, but good history for the most part, except for Bayley's attack on Kairi.
And it's like a communal championship. I mean, sure, Io is the women's champion, but it's like they all share the celebration.
Tag is made. Here comes Bayley.
Becky across now, tagging in the queen. Charlotte Flair has both Asuka and Bayley within sight. Crossbody taking down both.
A lot of history with Bayley and Charlotte as well.
Asuka and Charlotte were also tag team champions together.
Charlotte that initially ended Asuka's undefeated streak in WWE, a streak that many thought would never be broken.
Look at the most decorated female superstar of all time going to work now. Flair.
You say that about Charlotte Flair, and you're absolutely correct, but let's give Bayley her flowers as well, okay? Bayley's a Grand Slam champion in WWE.
That she is. Bayley ready to compete with anybody, but Charlotte may put Bayley away here. Cover for the win. Bayley kicking out.
It comes down to obsession to be the greatest. Charlotte has it. It's in her DNA. Becky Lynch has it. She had to dig down deep in her soul to find it. Both women have shown the world why they are the greats, but there can only be one, and that eats at both of them every day.
Up and over goes the queen.
Corey, what does it tell you about Bayley and damage control and their rise? Hang on a second, cover! Their rise and dominance that actually gets Charlotte and Becky to work together.
It's brilliant. It's absolutely magnificent mind games orchestrated by Bayley.
Well, Bayley had just an unbelievable plan a couple of SummerSlams ago when she brought this group together. Which is now turning.
Hooking the leg now. Charlotte Flair and Bayley kicking
into this incredibly dominant faction. Let's not forget that this is the brainchild of Bayley. And as much as I like to get on Bayley and get all over, this is the brainchild of her damage control.
You feeling okay, Cole? Tag is made.
That's my one.
Charlotte looking for the figure four! Code breaker by Asuka.
What timing from Asuka to get the win now. Charlotte out just in time.
Imagine the damage these women are going to do tomorrow night inside a cage where there are no rules. Weapons can be used. Bang! No disqualifications, no countouts.
That's the beauty of it, Cole. Come tomorrow, we won't have to imagine. We can just sit down and enjoy.
It's one point Bianca Belair made earlier tonight saying they can't bring any weapons. They won't have any numbers advantage tomorrow night unless, of course, they get the advantage with the pole. Cover now and Becky Lynch in the way.
Lynch sent spilling to the outside, courtesy of Asuka and Bayley, but the queen continues to fight. And a chop block by the Roma.
Again, the veteran instinct of Bayley. Knows Charlotte so well. Becky begging to make a tag.
And think about what drives Bayley, Cole. After all these years, you always hear the conversation. Is it Becky? Is it Charlotte? Bayley believes she deserves to be in that same conversation.
Well, of course, one of the original four horsewomen.
And the same could be said for Asuka. There's a lot driving damage control.
Driving into the corner here.
Io Sky as well, proving that she is a great champion.
And don't forget about Kairi, who's got to be eager to reestablish herself here in WWE.
Oh, here goes Lynch. Has Asuka and Bayley where she wants to.
Double DDT by Becky.
Becky now for the cover and the victory, and Bayley kicking out.
And look at, you're looking, I think, at the wild card in this whole thing tomorrow, Shotzi. She's unhinged. You saw how she acted earlier tonight. God knows what she's capable of inside the cage tomorrow night. We're talking so much about all these other women. Let's not forget Shotzi. She's unhinged.
Damage control costs her so much pain and emotional turmoil. Becky now! Missile dropkick. Grabs Bayley for the cover. Can she do it? And Bayley out once more.
Lynch looking to transition right into the disarm her.
Will Bayley tap out center of the ring?
Asuka. Man, this is devastating from behind.
And this could be the problem tomorrow night, too. There are no tags. You're going to have, at one point, eight women in two rings.
Uh-oh. Bayley was looking for the rose plant. Great counter by Lynch. Belly to back suplex.
He got planted all right.
But if chemistry comes into play tomorrow, you've got to think damage control have a major advantage.
100%.
Slam! He's going to do it.
Charlotte just speared Asuka, but unintentionally onto Becky Lynch.
It looked like Becky had the win.
That was friendly fire. There was nothing intentional there.
Bayley taking advantage.
That was very intentional. Bayley's down.
Look at the quick percussion. Yeah, she's got it.
And guys, here's the problem. Something like that set both Becky and Charlotte off to the point where their concentration was so maxed up, it cost them the match.
It could very well be like looking into a crystal ball.
I was gonna say, Bianca better get in there and start playing Peacekeeper.
Former comrades turned bitter rivals. Becky Lynch and Charlotte better get on the same page ahead of tomorrow's War Games.
I'm with Corey, though. I don't think anything was intentional here tonight. It's just, there's so much personal animosity.
Bring on tomorrow night, folks.
Damage controller locked and loaded. Becky Lynch's team looks like it's in big trouble.